Greg's T-scope elbow premier post-op brace is designed for fixed or controlled range of motion in the treatment of ligamentous injuries and stable fractures of the elbow or upper arm. The brace is comfortable, lightweight, simple to apply, and easily adjustable for a personal fit. The patented user-friendly T-scope premier hinge can be locked out to restrict flexion and extension at any angle to control the range of motion of the patient's elbow. When worn correctly and for the length of time prescribed by a medical professional, the brace helps post-surgery patients recover safely and comfortably. T-scope elbow premier braces will not prevent or reduce all injuries. Proper rehabilitation and activity modification are also an important part of a safe treatment program. Patients using the T-scope elbow premier should consult with a medical professional regarding safe and appropriate activity levels while wearing this brace. The initial application of the T-scope elbow premier braces should be performed by a medical professional only. Now let's fit the T-scope elbow premier brace on the patient. Unlock the telescope locks on the forearm and humeral bars by rotating the locks in a counterclockwise fashion. It's suggested that you use the quarter to rotate the telescoping locks. Then, unfasten the straps and fold them back onto themselves so they don't tangle. Hold the brace up to the arm with the hinge centered over the elbow joint. The quick lock on the hinge must be facing the patient's hand for proper orientation. Slide the telescope bars until they match the length of the upper arm and forearm. Lock the telescope locks by rotating clockwise. Then, while supporting the injured arm, fasten the forearm strap closest to the hinge by inserting the strap through the D-ring, pulling it tight, and then attaching the Velcro piece to the strap. Fasten the arm strap closest to the hinge. Then, fasten the upper arm furthest from the hinge. Lastly, fasten the strap closest to the hand. Patients experiencing any increased pain, swelling, skin irritation, or any adverse reactions when using T-scope elbow premier braces must contact a healthcare provider immediately. Now let's talk about the range of motion hinge. Only a medical professional should adjust or change range of motion hinge settings. The hinge on this brace is designed to limit and/or control range of motion. Patients should follow their physician's advice regarding activity level while wearing the brace. The spring-loaded tabs may be adjusted to limit the range of motion. Extension settings can be set between negative 10 degrees, hyperextension, and 120 degrees, while the flexion settings can be set to 0 degrees, and 120 degrees. To adjust the extension settings, pull the tab out away from the center of the hinge and slide it to the desired settings. Make sure the tab is secured in the correct position. Similar to a speedometer, there's a combination of numbers and tick marks that represent the extension and flexion settings on the hinge. For example, here is 30 degrees flexion and here is 40 degrees flexion. To adjust the flexion settings, pull the tab out away from the center of the hinge and slide it to the desired position. Make sure the tab is secured in the correct position. To prevent range of motion, lock the T-scope elbow premier brace by sliding the hinge lock towards the center of the hinge after positioning the arm at the appropriate angle. The hinge may be locked by sliding the red quick lock button into the locked position at any setting. Now we'll apply the shoulder strap. Position it over the patient's shoulder with the strap pad located behind the neck. The D-ring on each end of the shoulder strap will attach to the upper arm strap closest to the hinge and the forearm strap closest to the hand. Attach the upper arm strap by sliding the alligator tab at the end of the strap through the D-ring on the end of the shoulder strap. Pull the strap completely through the D-ring and fasten firmly. The D-ring on the shoulder strap should be properly positioned behind the arm to support the arm. Next, attach the forearm strap by sliding the alligator tab at the end of the strap through the D-ring at the end of the shoulder strap. Pull the strap completely through the D-ring and fasten firmly. To adjust the length of the strap, loosen the strap, pull the strap through the D-ring until the forearm is held at the proper elevation. Reattach the shoulder strap back to itself. The T-scope elbow premier neutral hand accessory is intended to reduce pronation and supination of the hand and wrist. The neutral hand accessory should be attached to the end of the T-scope elbow premier brace closest to the hand. Start by removing the wrist pad and strap from that end of the brace. Next, lead the nose of the brace end into the neutral hand accessory and snap them together. Ensure the accessory is locked to the brace by pinching the edges of the accessory to the brace with the thumb tabs. Then, replace the strap and wrist pad that were removed in the first step. Finally, with the T-scope elbow premier brace properly applied to the affected arm, wrap the strap on the neutral hand accessory around the hand. The hand and wrist are now secured and pronation and supination will be reduced. To remove the neutral hand accessory, first remove the wrist pad and strap from the T-scope elbow premier brace. Next, depress both thumb clips to separate the proximal edges from the brace. Hold the neutral hand accessory and the T-scope elbow premier brace and then collapse together, separating the parts. Finally, replace the strap and wrist pad to the elbow brace. After the initial fitting and application, the T-scope elbow premier brace may be removed and reapplied easily. Align the hinge over the center of the elbow joint and apply the straps to the D-rings and affix the Velcro tabs. The patient will not have to adjust anything else on the brace. Straps and foam pads may be removed by sliding the straps out of the strut housings. Hand wash the foam pads and straps with mild soap, rinse thoroughly with fresh water, and air dry. Do not place pads or straps into a mechanical dryer. If you have any questions about how to apply T-scope elbow premier braces, refer to the instructions for use pamphlet. Patients with questions about elbow bracing should contact their healthcare provider. Extra straps and foam pads are available from customer care at 800-321-0607. The straps may be shortened by trimming the excess strap with scissors and reattaching the alligator strap tab. For a more intimate fit, the telescoping struts can be contoured. After contouring the bars, they may no longer telescope, so setting the length first is imperative. Also, be careful to avoid damaging the hinge when contouring the side bars. Place the brace on a tabletop with one strut protruding off of the edge. Apply downward pressure to bend the strut. Ask your Breg sales rep about the T-scope elbow premier. You can also call Breg at 1-800-321-0607 or visit breg.com to learn more.